Hello and welcome to the DFS Army YouTube channel. I am Razzle11 or Razzle11Grinds on Twitter, bringing you a look at the pitching options on this slate on Monday, April 3rd. We have an interesting slate of pitching. Looks like an 11-game main slate on DraftKings, and I generally use DraftKings as my main option. Because I feel like pitching becomes pivotal on DraftKings more with the two-pitcher site. So let's take a look at what we have to work with. First guy up on my list here is going to be Charlie Morton. Now, Charlie Morton's going to be a guy that I am looking to fade in this spot. He just was not very strong away from home last year. As you can see, ERA near 6, average against of 3.32, a whip of over 1.42, a huge drop in K rate as well away from home. Just not a great spot. Allowed 17 home runs and 85 and a third innings away from Atlanta last year. And now he gets a St. Louis team that is swinging it well and full of some power bats. So we can see that he faced St. Louis once last year and gave up 2 home runs in 5 innings. So it's just not the best of spots. And I just don't want to pay $9,600 for Charlie Morton on this slate. And next we will go to... Let's try to take a look at Jose Berrios. I think there's going to be some people that just blindly go with him being against KC. KC starting out 0-3, not being able to score runs against the Twins. And this one kind of hurts me because I am a Berrios fan. Obviously came up with the Twins. But there's some things that are concerning. As similar to Morton, Berrios was terrible on the road last year. Now I understand some of that came with pitching in New York and Boston, a couple of parks that are obviously great for hitters. But as you can see, he threw the ball to an ERA of 6.36 on the road, a whip of 1.53, and a batting average against a 3.45, allowing 18 home runs in 80 and two-thirds innings away from Toronto last year. There are a couple of Kansas City bats that I think can take advantage of him, as he really struggled with left-handed hitters in 2022. So I just don't feel like 9,100 is worth the price on this slate for a guy like Berrios, who I think might take a little bit to get into the season. I mean, I hope I'm wrong because I am a fan, but this just does not seem like the spot where we want to take that chance, I guess. But I wouldn't blame you if you added a couple shares just because, you know, the matchup overall, in theory, is strong. He wasn't the sharpest over the spring. I know we can take some spring numbers with a grain of salt, but there are just things coming into this matchup that I just don't think work in our favor, so I want to look elsewhere. We can start with one of the elsewheres. Unfortunately, like, I expect this guy to be fairly popular. We picked on Washington a bit with some Atlanta pitching. Didn't necessarily work out the greatest for us. Obviously, Freed got hurt. Strider was great. Schuster really struggled, which was shocking. Having some troubles with the walks, which we really didn't expect going into the game. So, you know, it hasn't been the greatest spot, but... Drew Rasmussen is just solid. Not, you know, doesn't have a ton of upside overall, but I think on the slate we just go with the solid play. Now, similar to the first two pitchers I talked about, he has did struggle a little bit more on the road, not as extreme as the other two. He just was far more dominant at home, which we can expect with Tampa Bay at home. But the one worry, I guess, with Drew Rasmussen is the fact that he did only throw 9 2/3 in the spring. So I do wonder if maybe he's limited to 5 innings out of the gate, which is kind of frustrating. But given the pitching options on the slate, I think we can accept a strong 5 inning start out of him. And another guy that I am going to go with is going to be Reed Detmers. I realize he's an underdog facing a pretty strong pitcher in I think George Kirby. Sorry about that. But all of the reports about Reed Detmers this spring is that his stuff has taken a jump. Everything he's thrown has taken a leap at about 5 miles per hour. Now, we don't know if that's something that'll continue, or if that he'll come out into the start of the season and tone it down a little bit, because it is a long season. But those are some promising things for a young pitcher who obviously threw a no-hitter last year. So I am very intrigued. And we saw the Cleveland pitching staff do pretty well in Seattle, and we see that last year Detmers faced Seattle twice, beat them twice. Allowed just 2 runs in 13 innings of work. So I know that he is a slight underdog, but I really like the upside he offers us in this spot. I would much rather pay 8,200 for him than any of the guys that are over 9K, to be honest, on this slate. One pitcher that I'm kind of torn on what to do with is Hunter Brown. Gets the an absolute elite matchup against Detroit. But he dealt with some lower back issues this spring. Has been kind of limited. I'm not really sure what his innings upside is. I would not be shocked if he comes out and only throws 4 innings, but I also wouldn't be shocked if he does, five to maybe six. I think six is pushing it based on the number of innings he threw this spring, and obviously dealing with a lower back issue. But he made two starts, I believe, two starts last year with the Astros. One happened to be against this Detroit team, where he went six and struck out six, allowing just 2 runs. But he's in a great spot, so I will be most likely heavy on him, but there is some concern about the true upside. But that's kind of the story on this slate a bit about some of the pitching options. I actually like the overall options more today than yesterday, but there's just a lot of question marks that go around some of them. So I just don't think we're gonna see some, ridiculous, Jeffrey Springs type performance today out of any pitchers. There is a guy down here, I think Michael Grove or Cutter Crawford at their price points are gonna be pretty popular, and I understand it. Pittsburgh has a higher run total than I would have expected, so that does give me some worry in this spot. But I do like Cutter Crawford a little bit, and Michael Grove is somebody that will carry ownership for sure. He did struggle in his one start against Colorado last season, but I think we see a pretty strong game out of him today against Colorado. So, all right, that's the look at some of the pitching options and who we're looking to use and even fade on this slate. If you enjoyed the content, please hit the like. It really helps us out here at DFS Army. And right now we're running a promo code of opening day to get you 50% off your membership here at DFS Army. And I'll put a link in the description. Leave a comment with who you think is the best fade on this slate, and I'll take a look at it, and hopefully we can get those right. Best of luck, everybody.